Hated by arachnophobes and tourists alike, the Huntsman spider is notorious for its long, spindly legs, lightning-fast movement, and its sheer size alone is enough to send shivers down your spine.
That is the biggest spider.
And like the redback spider, the Huntsman will now also lend its name to one of Australia's new military capabilities, the AS9 Huntsman self-propelled howitzer, a powerful artillery system designed to deliver devastating firepower on the battlefield. And while the Huntsman spider is terrifying but harmless to humans, the AS9 Huntsman aims to be quite the opposite of that. A deadly, lethal force that may just give the Australian Army an edge in any future conflicts. This new piece of equipment will revolutionise the way the Royal Australian Artillery Corps goes about its work. But what are the capabilities of the Huntsman? When are we getting them? How much will they cost? And where are they being built? I'm Mel Pikos, and today we're talking tactics. At long last, Australia is finally getting some self-propelled artillery. As I mentioned, it's named after the fearsome Huntsman spider and is actually based on the South Korean K9 Thunder design. This vehicle will provide the Australian Army with some much-needed shoot and scoot ability. That is, the ability to move quickly into an area of the battlefield, undertake a fire mission, and then just as quickly relocate before the enemy has a chance to locate it. We're also procuring a number of AS10 armoured ammunition resupply vehicles, which are capable of resupplying the Huntsmans while under heavy fire. Technically, the AS9 and the AS10s are both considered to be part of the Huntsman family of vehicles, but for convenience, I'll just refer to the AS9 as the Huntsman and the resupply vehicle as the AS10. Let's dive in and see what they can do. What is the Huntsman? The AS9 Huntsman is a 155mm self-propelled howitzer based on an updated version of South Korea's K9 Thunder design. These are from Hanwha, the same company responsible for bringing us the AS21 Redback infantry fighting vehicle, which we have featured previously on this channel, with two of its newest bits of kit named after arachnids. Maybe the Australian Army is here to f*** spiders after all. The K9 is a proven design with over 2,400 already manufactured and 9 nations across the world using the platform. This seems like a pretty sure bet for delivering the promised capability. And what is that capability? Although it looks like a tank, it's better to think of the Huntsman as an artillery gun on tracks. The Huntsman is armoured enough to provide a level of protection to its crew, but not enough to allow it to get into firefights with actual main battle tanks. The Huntsman is what is known as a protected mobile fires platform, or self-propelled artillery. For this video, we'll go with self-propelled artillery. The main advantage of self-propelled artillery, like the Huntsman, compared to the more traditional towed artillery, like the M777A2, which the Australian Army currently operates, is that it can get in and out of the action much more quickly. Towed artillery needs to be, as the name suggests, towed into position, then unlimbered, set up, and then fired. The Huntsman, in comparison, can drive itself to a position and start firing almost immediately. It can then quickly move to another position to avoid counter battery fire, which is becoming a bigger and bigger concern on the modern battlefield. The Huntsman can also fire faster than the M777 and can fire burst rounds of several shells timed to hit a target simultaneously. These factors provide the Huntsman with a major advantage in maneuver warfare or when artillery needs to keep pace with an advance. The Huntsmans the Australian Army will be receiving will be supported by AS10 armoured ammunition resupply vehicles, which are up-armoured versions of the original South Korean K10 ammunition resupply vehicles. Each AS10 can be loaded with around 100-155mm shells and uses an automated control system to transfer shells to the Huntsmans at a rate of up to 12 rounds per minute. These vehicles allow the Huntsmans to be reloaded in the field, even when under fire, rather than each individual Huntsman having to fall back to a rear position or even a supply depot to reload. So what are the specs for the Huntsman and the AS10? Specifications. The Huntsman has a combat weight of 52 tonnes and an overall length of 12.4 metres. It's 3.5 metres wide and 3.7 metres high. It's built around a 155mm 52 calibre artillery barrel with a semi-automated loading system designed to reduce the crew's workload and increase its rate of fire. Speaking of crew, the Huntsman has a crew of up to 5 and a maximum speed of 60 kilometres per hour. The fire rate of the Huntsman's is between 6 and 8 rounds a minute, which it can maintain until it has spent its ammunition stores. It can also fire 3 rounds in a 15 second burst, allowing it to focus a huge amount of firepower on a target in a short period. Compared to the K9 Thunder it is based on, the AS9 Huntsman will have improved crew protection and advanced digital capabilities. These include Plasan add-on armor and spall liners, as well as enhanced suspension and air conditioning for hot climates and crew comfort. The firing range of the Huntsman varies based on the type of shell fired, but it is capable of firing the M982 Excalibur round, an extended range guidance shell with a range of up to 60 kilometers, depending on the variant used. The Excalibur munition is a precision guided artillery shell capable of striking within 10 meters of its target, even at distances of up to 60 kilometers, making it far more accurate than conventional rounds. And the standard high explosive HE shells that the Huntsman can also fire offer 3 primary detonation modes: impact explosion for direct hits, delayed fuse to penetrate and destroy hardened targets, and airburst to maximize shrapnel spread over a wider area. This versatility allows the Huntsman to adapt to different battlefield scenarios with lethal efficiency. The Huntsman will use a modern fire control system supplied by Kongsberg Defence Australia, as well as a R400 remote weapon station supplied by EOS. The R400, as well as a pintle mount, can be equipped with 5.56mm or 7.62mm machine guns to provide the Huntsman with anti-infantry protection. The R400 could even be equipped with a 50 cal machine gun or automatic 40mm grenade launcher. Each Huntsman will also be equipped with a Minio direct fire support system capable of linking into both the fire control system and the R400 station to provide direct fire aiming capability. And the AS10's specs? The specifications of the AS10 are similar to the Huntsman, as it uses the same tracked chassis. However, the AS10 is 47 tons, can carry up to 104 155mm shells and 504 charges. It has a maximum speed of 67 kilometers per hour and a crew of 3. The AS10 will also feature a pintle mount, which can mount a machine gun. The fully automated loader ensures that the AS10 can resupply Huntsmans in the field without exposing the crew. An AS10 can transfer ammunition at a maximum speed of 12 rounds per minute. Compared to the K10, which it is based on, the AS10 also has enhanced armor and crew protection. So how did we end up with this platform? The long road to acquisition. The Australian Army has wanted self-propelled artillery for a long time. It became increasingly common through the Cold War, as artillery units needed to be able to keep up with mechanised forces and provide protection for their crews in a more lethal modern battlefield. However, through the entire Cold War period, the Australian Army had to make do with towed artillery. Now, as part of the Army transitions to a modern mechanised force, the artillery guys are finally getting their hands on this bit of kit. The start of acquisition planning for the Huntsman's dates all the way back to 2005, when Australian and South Korean defence ministers discussed the potential for Australia to acquire K9 Thunders. By 2010, the K9 was being evaluated by the Australian Army, and later in the year became the preferred bidder for Australia's Land 17 artillery replacement program. In 2012, in an arguably short-sighted decision by the Gillard government, the project was cancelled after its funding had been redirected to recovery from the 2011 Queensland floods the previous year. In 2019, the Morrison government resurrected the program with an agreement signed between Defence and Hanwha in 2021 for 30 Huntsmans and 15 AS10s to be built at Hanwha Defence Australia's facility in Geelong. This project, known as Land 8116 Phase 1, was to be followed by a repeat order for the same quantity, Land 8116 Phase 2. However, in 2023, the Albanese government cancelled Phase 2 in favour of redirecting funding to the M142 HIMARS, as recommended by the 2023 Defence Strategic Review. This decision means that the Royal Artillery Corps will be left with only enough Huntsmans to equip one regiment, which at this stage is stated to be the 4th Regiment, Royal Australian Artillery. Manufacturing in Geelong. In January 2025, Australia received its first two Huntsmans, as well as an AS-10, all constructed in South Korea. The remaining vehicles are to be built at the Hanwha Armoured Vehicle Centre of Excellence, or HACE, in Geelong, just outside of Avalon Airport. HACE was opened on the 23rd of August 2024, with construction of the Huntsmans expected to have started by the end of that year. The factory is scheduled to have delivered all AS-9s and AS-10s to the Australian Army by 2027. This factory represents a major development in Australia's defence industry, providing another Australian facility to build armoured vehicles alongside Rheinmetall Defence Australia's Ipswich factory, which is where the Boxer Combat Reconnaissance Vehicle is being built. It's estimated that 300 jobs will be created over the life of the construction project. The entire cost of the Huntsman project is estimated to be around about 1 billion Australian dollars. The HACE facility will be further expanded this year so that the 129 Redback infantry fighting vehicles of Land 400 Phase 3 can be built concurrently with the Huntsmans. Were we right to cancel half the Huntsman's order? So at long last, the Australian Army is getting some self-propelled artillery. Just not as many as the Army originally wanted. Did the Australian government make the right decision to halve the number of Huntsmans by cutting Land 8116 Phase 2? It's hard to call. While in general, defence should be attracting more funding if projects need it, the reality is that the Australian government has been reluctant to increase overall defence spending enough in recent years. Therefore, when a higher priority project needs to be funded, often it means that a project that is identified as lower priority gets a reduction. This happened with the Huntsmans and it's happened with the Redbacks. Given the increasing geopolitical tensions in our region, having an army equipped with two regiments of self-propelled artillery probably isn't a huge ask. One of the issues with reducing the number of units delivered in a project is that it almost always results in unit costs increasing. Sometimes this means that defence only receives a small saving, despite the number of platforms delivered being halved or more. On the other hand, the Royal Australian Artillery is a modestly sized corps, which was often neglected when it came to funding and equipment during the global war on terror era. Now, suddenly with the war in Ukraine and China building up its forces, everyone has suddenly rediscovered the importance of long-range firing systems. The Australian Artillery Corps will be responsible for operating the Huntsmans, as well as the HIMARS and the new Air Defence National Advanced Surface-to-Air Missile System. It's a big job for a relatively small part of the Army, which needs to get a fair bit bigger in the next few years. Maybe halving the number of Huntsmans being delivered will take some pressure off. Another thing to consider is that even though earlier I was singing the praises of self-propelled artillery compared to towed artillery, it is important that we maintain both capabilities. Self-propelled artillery is great on open terrain, so would be really well suited for continental defence or certain deployments. However, the 2023 Defence Strategic Review emphasised the importance of the Australian Army being able to conduct amphibious operations in Australia's littoral. Towed artillery pieces are lighter and smaller, and so are better able to be transported by ship or aeroplane. Also, many of the islands to Australia's north are mountainous and or jungled, meaning that they're often not suited for big 50-ton vehicles to bush bash around. But with only three line artillery regiments, the Australian Army doesn't have a lot of gunners to spread around while trying to retain multiple capabilities. But what do you think? Is one unit of Huntsmans enough? Or should we have bought more so that we could equip another regiment? Do we need self-propelled artillery guns? And what should the ADF be gearing up with next? I'd love to read your thoughts in the comments section down below. If you got something out of this video, hit that like button, and if you're enjoying my content, subscribe now so you don't miss the next video on Australia's HIMARS acquisition. A very special thank you to Todd Newitt, our newest contributor to Talking Tactics. Todd has got some great analysis that is helping take our content to the next level. We hope you enjoyed today's video. That's it for today. I'm Mel Pikos, and we've been Talking Tactics.